John Wilson, season 2. If you don't know John Wilson, he is a filmmaker, and he's got a series on HBO called How To with John Wilson. Season 1 was really good. I thought season 2 was even better. There's something he's got, some sort of quality he's got about the way he looks at the world. It's humorous, it's authentic, it's original, it feels like truth. I will say this, and by the way, I'm just going to say New York. I love New York. I love New Yorkers. Don't jump all over me. But in this series, New York looks like a mental asylum, basically. I mean, you get people sucking toes in cars, other people walking around with stuffed animals as pets. I don't mean kids either. Just crazy shit, man. And I think that's, you know, it's intentional, right? He's putting it into the film. This guy's shooting film all day long. He's baking that into the series. He's showing you people in New York. I'm not saying it's all people. I'm not trying to generalize. But it looks crazy. I don't know why anyone would live in New York. There was an episode where he was going around looking at different places before he bought his old landlord's, his friend, her building. They were showing him, like, it was literally like kitchen and the shower was next to the oven. I stayed in a hotel in New York once and literally the toilet was like next to the TV or like just behind it. I mean, and it's crazy. Like, why would you, this is a huge planet. I get that, you know, there's a reason that people go to urban centers or cities because there's creative energy, there's juices, there's all kinds of like risk taking and things like that. Great food happening at all times of the night. Shows, movies, got it. I don't know if it's not post-COVID world because it's still going on and we don't know how long it's going to continue to go on, but that certainly changes things. Come on, like it's hard to argue I would argue that there are other cities that beat New York or are close to it. Of course, like London and Paris are great. I love LA personally. But in terms of like what it offers you in return for like a $3,000, 600 square foot studio. I mean, why would you do that? There are oceans and lakes and mountains to climb. Like, what? It doesn't need to happen anymore. Maybe in the old days, you had to be there and you had to like, you know, schmooze up to like directors and casting directors and script writers, and you had to befriend people. And it still helps to do that for sure, I think. Not that I know anything about that world. I'm just saying, like, it seemed like creatives had to go either to New York or LA, maybe Chicago, to sort of make it in that world and network and get connections. You don't have to do that anymore. You can do a podcast from anywhere. You can do stand-up on Zoom, which probably doesn't, I'm not a stand-up, but it doesn't sound like that's a good way to go about it. But you could do lots of things online. You could sell your music on Bandcamp or on iTunes or Amazon, even though they take 30% of the cut. Isn't that crazy? That's a ripoff. But anyway, I don't want to digress, but the way you portrayed New York in there makes it very unappealing to me, even though it's interesting. It is interesting, but it's also just looks dirty and like, ugh. I mean, I just remember thinking all of it, like curling up like the blankets to my bed, like, oh, New York, ugh. I mean, I live in Detroit, but whatever. You know, we got our own problems too. It's a different set of problems, but I'm comfortably in the suburbs here in a house, which I love. Because I like having a backyard and I like my husky puppy to be able to run among trees and not like people sucking each other's toes in cars and looking like they're getting zero joy out of it, you know, or whatever it is that people were doing, licking sidewalks or I don't know. But I thought the series was great. I highly recommend it. I think he's got such a great way of telling a story. And it's so focused. And with each episode, it's like how to make, how to pay your taxes, how to make the perfect risotto, how to, you know, search for an apartment or whatever. There's something great about the specificity of those episodes, because then it's almost like, it's weird, but when you go specific or you sort of hone in on a topic or a theme, it oddly becomes more universal, which I think really works. I'll tell you a quick story. In Michigan here, there's a smaller city where there's a community foundation where they gave these really nice cameras, not to keep, but they let these elementary school kids have them for an afternoon and let them take pictures of things or whatever they wanted to do, right? Summertime, they're out wandering around in a park or something. And what was interesting was that all of the pictures were very close up. Like, if it was a flower petal, it was like right on it. Or if it was a fence, it was like right up on it. They were zoned in. And there's something interesting there, because it's like when we get older, it seems like we tend to like zoom out and try to take in the whole thing, thinking that that's going to give us a better perspective on something. But the moving in and focusing on the element as everything has a really interesting perspective, I think, and that that goes a long way. And I think it maybe even says more than if you sort of panned, zoomed out and saw everything. Like, seeing a picture of Earth from space, it doesn't tell you anything. I mean, it tells you something, but it doesn't have the same comment or gesture or message as if you zoomed all the way into Earth, into a person's face in sub-Saharan Africa or in Beijing or Portland, Oregon. You know, what they're doing, like someone having a coffee in Portland, Oregon. Trust me, somebody's having a cup of coffee in Portland, Oregon. Sort of with their head down like this in front of their laptop, writing their book that's not going to get published. You know, that says something more than if you just took a picture of Earth. So anyway, I like the specific quality of his works. It's just so entertaining. You can't stop watching it. Good sense of humor. And I didn't think the first season could be topped. I think it has been topped. I look forward to season 3 or his next project. I don't know. He doesn't have to go on with this. It's not Friends or The Office. You don't have to keep going. But I highly recommend HBO, How To with John Wilson, out now. All 6 episodes. There's only 6 episodes of about 25, 30 minutes. And that's the same for this first season too, I think. All right. Patreon.com/ArtHouseRadio if you want to support. Thank you for watching this. Please support more. There's you can go to arthouse43.com if you want to make a donation. We've got the Patreon page is big. Please subscribe if you can. I hope you have a wonderful January 2022. Omicron. Let me know what films you're watching too. And what you thought of John Wilson, if you saw it. All right.